we discussed in the starting of perceptual organization that there are two processes which is responsible for perceptual organization. One of them is top-down processing. This processing is defined as development of pattern recognition through the use of contextual information. It plays an important role in improving our memory. Just imagine that you visited your village 1 year back, and I'm sure the development occurs very rapidly. So, how do you locate your own house or your friend's house, the one you visited 1 year back? I'm sure you must have done some visual marking to remember the location. So, in this chapter, we'll discuss certain technology and certain techniques to improve your memory. Let's think, is it really possible to improve your memory? If you are ever found yourself forgetting where you left your keys or blanking out information on important tests, then you have probably wished that your memory was a bit better. Fortunately, there are plenty of things that you can do to help to improve your memory. So let's discuss certain techniques to improve your memory given by famous psychologist. But to start with, what is exactly memory? I'll just give you a glimpse of it. Memory is a faculty of the brain by which information is encoded, stored, and retrieved when we need it. Often memory is understood as an informational processing system with explicit and implicit functioning that is made of sensory processors. Short-term memory and long-term memory. To encode, store and retrieve the information from our memory is always not easy. Most of the time, it is difficult for the students to encode the information. As a result, storing does not occur and retrieval, of course, not possible. Therefore, many researchers developed certain techniques or methods for improving memory and store information as long as possible. These are five major techniques for improving our memory. To start with, the first technique is mnemonics. Mnemonic is a word for memory tool for improving memory. Mnemonics are techniques for remembering information that is otherwise quite difficult to recall. Simple example is 30 days has September. The rhyme from remembering numbers of days in each calendar month. The idea behind using mnemonics is to encode difficult to remember information in a way that is much easier to remember. Mnemonics make use of elaborative encoding, retrieval cues, and imagery as specific tools to encode any given information in a way that allows for efficient storage and retrieval in time. Mnemonics aid original information in becoming associated with something more accessible or meaningful, which in turn provides better retention of information. Mnemonics vary in effectiveness for several groups ranging from young children to elderly. Mnemonic learning strategies requires time and resources by educators to develop creative and effective devices. The second technique for improving memory is organization. Organized information is always easy to find. One way to create meaning to learn from general to specific. I'm sure students, you must be making notes at your home. While making notes, you use different colors of pen and pencil. Sometimes you draw a table or make a figure for your better understanding. As a technique to improve your memory, organization enables to arrange the random information to a meaningful way. Richard Saul Warman is an American architect and graphic designer who wrote in his book, Five Principles of Organizing Information, and these techniques nowadays are used by all the disciplines to make their memory more effective. So let's discuss briefly what are the five principles of organization. First principle is location, geographic or spatial reference. This skill is important when you need to find ways or you need to prioritize in a map where to go and how to go to a new place, or where is exactly the exit map of a shopping complex or of any form. Principle 2 is alphabets, alphabetical sequence. It is beneficial when information is referential or when no other organizing principle is appropriate. Principle 3 is time, the chronological sequence. I'm sure all of you must have done a course on history in your 8th standard, 9th standard or 10th standard. How do you exactly remember the years of the kings that ruled our country? Or when you want to study more in-depthly about history, it is always easy to make a sequence of arrival the king in India. Example, a TV guide or a step-by-step guide will definitely help you to remember efficiently. The fourth principle is organized by category, similarity or relatedness. Think of the various areas in a department store, or imagine that you are in a mall. It's not a new mall, most of the time you visit that mall, and how they arrange their items in a mall is a correct example of organizing it based on their category. The fifth principle is organized by continuum, order of magnitude. Example, highest to lowest, best to worst, or good to bad. Coming to the third technique of improving memory is elaborative techniques. This technique helps by relating new information to codes already stored and familiar to you. Elaborative interrogation or technique is a strategy best suited to a situation where the information you wish to learn relates to rich network of information in your database. This is a strategy to help you remember meaningful information. Let's first see an example of elaborative techniques. Example, here are certain facts about a human body organ, heart. Arteries are thick and elastic, and it carries blood that is rich in oxygen from the heart. Veins are thinner, less elastic, and carry blood rich in carbon dioxide back to the heart. Now, if you know nothing else about veins, arteries, what are the functionalities when they are in heart, then you may find difficult. So, to simplify how you can remember what is artery and vein, you have to elaborate the whole way. How to elaborate? There is an example. Just ask these four questions to you. Why do arteries need to be more elastic than veins? Why do arteries need to be thicker than veins? Why do arteries carry blood away from the heart? And the last question you should ask in the elaborative process is, why do arteries carry blood that is rich in oxygen? To be elaborative a little more, arteries are thick, elastic, because they carry blood from the heart, which pumps blood out in spurts. As a result, you can inhale. Veins are thin and less elastic because they carry blood to the heart in an even flow. So, all these facts, arteries are thick, elastic, and carry blood from the heart. Veins are thinner, less elastic, and carry blood back to the heart, are connected. If you still have some doubt, then think, what has any of this got to do with the fact that arteries carry blood rich in oxygen and veins carry blood rich in carbon dioxide? So the fact that arteries carry oxygen rich in blood connected to the fact that arteries carry blood from the heart. To be precise more, This is the whole process explained how we inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. Facts that you already know very well and have no trouble remembering act as anchor points in this. The more anchor points you can connect to, the more meaningful way new information it will be stored in your memory, and the more easily you will remember it and retrieve it whenever it is needed. The third technique of improving memory is rehearsal. This strategy is used as one of the very effective learning and memorizing strategy. A variety of strategies to rehearse or practice new learning are suggested in this section. Rehearsal strategies are learning techniques that help students to revisit content as much as possible. Memory, particularly the declarative memory, needs to be planted richly. These are the five rehearsal strategies which will improve your memory in future. First is visualization, second is foldable, third is story creation, fourth is pre-printed response cards, the lastly songs, raps or skit development. To focus on visualization, when a student have difficulty in visualizing, the following techniques may be used to help them. Ask the student to close their eyes and picture their classroom, thinking about the bird cage next to the door, the flash tank under the window, the hamster cage beside the sink, and the snake poster on the bulletin board. Then ask the students to open their eyes and write a list of animals for their science lab. This simple task will help them begin to visualize content material when needed. Foldable. Dina Zeig has invented hundreds of educational manipulative which she calls foldable. How it is developed? Using papers, teachers and students create books, pamphlets or study guides of subject content. Foldable are used as graphic organizers that help students to solve the problem, take better notes and improve study skills. The following picture is a foldable of parts of plant to be used as a study guide. Remember or imagine that when you started learning about other parts of a tree. This is root, that is trunk, that is a leaf. I'm sure you must have drawn the picture of the tree, then started identifying what is called what. The same way this foldable techniques use to improve your memory. Story creation. Creating a story can be used to increase students' retention and achievement. For example, using a fictional character, the teacher may tell students how seeds were purchased, planted where there was sunlight, and watered regularly to produce a healthy plant. This progression of events helps the students when they need to remember sequential or cyclical information in the science and social studies. Pre-printed response cards. When you all appeared your board exam in 10th standard, I'm sure you must have used this technique. Writing certain chemistry table in your wall or printing the chemistry table from your computer and pasted so that you can see it every time. One side of the card is the word, another side is written in the large print, or sometime you improve the font size or you make it so designed that your eyes will go to there and you can read it and retrieve it whenever you needed it. Pre-printed response card is very useful technique for any disciplined student to remember easily. For students in the upper grades, the definition and an example of sentence should be printed on the back of the card so that you will never forget it. Songs and raps or skits. I think these days every Hindi movie or Telugu movie you can see rap songs. Similarly, you can also write raps for your education material. Developing a song, rap or skit into the student's creative activity always improve the creative level of students and their intelligence and their memory. Coming to the last technique of improving memory is SPQ3R. I know the name sounds very unfamiliar, but these are the abbreviation of survey, predict, question, read, recite, and review. It is a method of improving memory. Initially, it was SQ3R, where predict was not there, but it was introduced by Francis P. Robinson, an American education philosopher, in his book 1946. The book's name is Effective Study. Later, after improving, it became SPQ3R. So, we'll discuss in-depthly what is this process and how to go about it. The first step is S, that is survey. It means you skim the chapter and observe the heading, subheadings, take a look at the figures and make a mental note of the overall layout, such as figures, tables and summary paragraphs, just like your reading material you always use. This survey takes around 3 to 5 minutes. Make a mental note of the words in the bold or italic letter. This allows you to get an overall picture and what the author considers as important. The second step is predict. Here you imagine, in other words, predict what the chapter will be about based on the survey you just did. The third step is questioning. Here you jot down any question that may have occurred to you after you did the survey. Following questions may raise in your mind, such as, what is the chapter all about? Second question it may came, what question is this chapter trying to answer? The third may be, how does this information help me? The question step again will take 3 to 5 minutes to complete, but it will motivate the reader to seek the answer to the questions. The fourth step is read, the most essential. With the above framework in mind, you read for deeper understanding, starting from the beginning of the chapter and end it. Keep your questions and predictions in your mind. Accordingly, read in order to answer those questions, and passive reading in contrast results in merely reading without engaging in the study material. Passive reading is always not supportive. I'm sure in your childhood, you are always told by your parents to read loud. That is called active reading, which helps your memory to improve and the information stored stays long time. The fifth step is recite. I'm sure you must be remembering you used to recite poem in your childhood at loud. Practice the same way exactly to remember the information given in your book or remember the answers for the exam you're going to appear. In this fifth step, when you reach the end of a particular passage or a section of chapter, you quiz yourself on the questions you have jotted down in the questioning section. Do you know the material well enough to answer the questions? It is a good idea to read and answer aloud to yourself. This recital step may be done either in an oral or written format. It is related to the benefits of retrieval in boosting long-term memory for the material. The last step is review. In this step, you should take a place a day after the other above steps have been completed. Go back to the review your questions and see if you can answer them all easily or not. If not, repeat the step again. The steps are S, P, Q and 3 R's. 3 R stands for read, recite and review. To conclude, applying all this technique will definitely help the students to improve their memory. Researchers have long known that sleep is important for memory and learning. Therefore, do get a well sleep every night. Researchers also shown that taking a nap after you're learning something new can actually help you to learn faster and remember better. Also, good diet is also important for your memory. Regularly learning are some of the ways to improve your memory. Thank you.